1, ready. Welcome everyone. Well, like the view from here is much better than from down, so I really encourage you to be here one day. So first, I want to excuse for my voice because I was really sick the last couple of days, and I had to take, I don't know, like a couple of dozen of medicament to be able to fly here. So just excuse my voice if it's not really clear. I'm here to talk about my personal experience in Egypt, even like 1 year before the revolution. I'm having an ongoing experience started 2010 with a business or a venture I started, which was one of the first co-working space in Egypt called The District. We started it in 2010. But allow me at the start, before starting, I need to share with you an extract of a real conversation I had 2 months ago with a random guy in the street. So it was like this. I was just walking in the street, and an old man just approached me. He was around in his 50s, and he told me, like, son, I need a favor from you. Can you hear? It wasn't you. So anyway, like the old man, like he approached me and he told me, like, the young man, the young man, sure, the very young spirit man. He approached me with a very simple question. He told me, son, I need a favor from you. At the start, I thought he's begging, he's just asking for money or direction, orientation. But he told me very seriously, I need you to ask you to go and ask your father, is he really happy with what you achieved in your life? Is he really satisfied with what you did? Does he really see hope for your future? At the start, I thought a little bit the guy is lunatic or crazy or whatever, but he had this real seriousness in his eye. So I didn't tell him about that I'm having my own business, I'm running and all this stuff. And I wanted to go and proceed with the conversation with him. So I asked him, like, why he's asking this question. And it happened that he told me, okay, like, now I'm a young spirit man who's 50 years old. I'm having a young kid, 20, just graduated from business administration. He didn't find a job. He stayed 2 years in the house at home, no employment. And now he's working as a delivery guy for Kushari, local shop store in Egypt. So, and then the man started make like a very simple calculation with me. He told me, like, all the amount of money I spend on my kid since kindergarten till he graduated from university, it was average around like 165,000 Egyptian pound. If I would keep the money, I could buy him now a decent house or a car, or even like give him some money to start his own business. The story continued, like we had a very long conversation, but for me, like this two sentence or the two questions that he told me, it was very deep and eye-enlightening for me. And I had so many indicators and conclusion coming out. One of this conclusion, that this guy, he doesn't really see any hope. Like the light at the end of the tunnel, he doesn't see it. While we were discussing, he was telling me during the conversation that when we did the revolution, or the young people did the revolution or started it in 2011, everyone was really happy. He saw like a change happening and coming. He saw a better future for himself and for his kids. But now after 2 years, he didn't expect that the journey would be difficult or would be long. And now he reached the moment when he doesn't really see any hope or any opportunity. And the light at the end of the tunnel is really dimming till he doesn't see it. For him, everything is black. For me, this was a very inspiring and very eye-enlightening and eye-opening experience. Because at the same time, since 2010, I had an idea that I developed passion for, which was, at that time, I wanted to start like an inspiring workspace where entrepreneurs can work together, can meet, can just mingle and chat and network with each other. And if I'm looking back, without the support I found in my surrounding circle, I couldn't really achieve my dream and my passion and start my own business now, which is called The District. And at that time, I remember like so many people were just like this type of nagging negative person who were giving you every single reason why your venture will fail or why your idea would fail, especially that was after the revolution. But for me, I had to be selective and switch off some people and switch on others. Like I want to surround myself with positive thinkers, positive people. And among these people, it was like my family, my older brother, he is here, I cannot see him, but like he will be speaking in a couple of minutes about how to create peace movement. And all these people, they didn't really understand what I want to do because like personally, I couldn't really phrase what I wanted. But these people, they were really just supportive. They were helping me create the momentum and start my business. From 2010 till 2011, a couple of months after the revolution, we started our first co-working space in Egypt. It was the district. At that time, we didn't have anyone. It was just me and another friend of mine. We were opening in the morning, and we didn't know if we're going to have any co-worker or any community member coming this day or not. And then as time goes by, the experience, I found that it's very inspiring to be co-working with others. Like, it's not just about the physical space. It's about being surrounding and interacting with other people. And that was very inspiring. That's democratizing resources, sharing knowledge, just not just meeting people, but interacting with people together. You are having a lifestyle together. You are having shared life within workspace. But after 2 years, I found that there are much more values coming from this. And I found that what happens in the district, or what we did, and I have to be frank with myself and honest, it was unintentional. I didn't have the idea in my mind that I want to create this alternative or parallel community. But what happened actually is now, if you're thinking like after 2 years, we created a parallel and alternative community. This community is ruled with set of morals and values that we chose ourselves. The basic thing about this rules and morals and values is about seeing opportunity, about hope. If I'm thinking about the guy I met or the story I was telling you at the start, can you imagine a whole population doesn't see any, or they don't see any hope? Everyone is really negative. There is no light. Everything is very pessimist. I would say like if we are just like going with this scenario of a complete population with no hope, there's only one conclusion or what consequences. Everyone just like grab from his pocket, switch button, switch off your life, and go somewhere else. But this is not what we decided. We decided in the district that we are gathering all people who seize opportunity, who want to change, who are persistent. And this is the power of community. The power of community is that you are bringing people together, create a place and or a space for interaction, and let them put the rules and the values and the morals that they want to believe and they want to live according. And then you will see like amazing things happening. One of the very inspiring stories that happened to me, and it was as well eye-enlightening. Last year, we had a young kid, a young guy who was like 19 or 20. His name was Sayed. Sayed was like almost illiterate, like he couldn't read or write. And he was helping us with cleaning, buying stuff. But as time goes by, Sayed was much more involved in the daily operation and like interacting with the coworker and our entrepreneurs. And it happened after 4 months, he was coming and telling me, Mazen, like when I'm dealing with you, and the more I'm staying in the district, I can see the future. And for a guy who doesn't really know how to read or write, it was a very honest and deep feeling that he was developing. The community of the district helped Sayed develop hope for the future. And now Sayed, after 4 months of working with us, he's not with us anymore, and he turned back to his hometown in Aswan with the intention of starting his own business, which is selling and supplies of sound tools and sound equipment. And that, for me, I found that, wow, maybe like the community that we are creating, the parallel community we are creating in the district, it shouldn't be just blocked inside the physical space of the district or between the walls of the district, but like someone like Sayed, he's going away into to different city, to different area with the same values and same moral, and he can start the same community. And that's how we can help our country, or we can help or we can change our future. Between all the entrepreneurs in the district, we're having one quote that we are all saying to each other. Every challenge or every problem we are facing today is a winning idea or business or social venture for the future. So it's not just about that you are seeing the empty or the filled part of the cup, but as well, it's about you are plugging yourself into the right community. And this is the lesson, the personal lesson I learned in my life. It's very good that you are developing passion for what you want. It's very good that you are really studying what you want to do. But the most important thing is that you need to plug yourself into the right community for you. And I'm not saying the right community because there is no absolute right, but there is the right community for you, the community that will help you achieve what you want. When it happens that we are asking our coworker in the district, like in a national holiday or whatever, do we really need to close that day? Are you coming or not? And then the simple answer that we were getting from them, like the entrepreneur here in the district, they are here to create and to work. They are not here wishing and dreaming of an extra day of holiday. So, and that's why, like at the start, we were having like limited working time. Now we are almost like opening and working every day because we found this is a chance for people to interact and keep plugged into a community that really fuel your momentum and fuel your energy with hope, positivity, and opportunity. Going every day, every morning to the district, and you see like all these cheerful faces that they are having really high expectations on you. Even if they don't know exactly in details what you are doing with your business or with your venture, but everyone, we see the opportunity everywhere. If someone is coming one day and telling us, okay, like they will raise taxes, we're saying, okay, ishta, just raise taxes, we'll keep working. The country will go bankrupt, fine. Even if the country bankrupt, but won't be canceled and deleted from the world map, will still be exist. So it's up to you to decide whether you are working or you are just staying and complaining and blaming someone else. So in the district, we decided that we are not waiting anything, any favor from anyone. We created our own parallel community with a set of rules and values and optimism and hope that we want. And this is how we see we can change our future. It's not just for us. It's for us, it's for our kids, and for the whole generation coming next after us. So like the question I need to ask you now, everyone is already like having a dream that they want to achieve. So you need to ask yourself, are you plugging yourself into the right community now? If the answer is yes, so you are very lucky. And if the answer is no, I'll just simply tell you, go and create your own community. Thank you.
Three, two, one, ready.